This is Optimal Living Daily, episode 786, a whirlwind tour of getting things done by Cal Newport of calnewport.com, and I'm Justin Mollick. Welcome back, or welcome for the first time if you're new here. This is where I simply narrate blogs for you, usually, sometimes books, all with permission from the websites. Today's author being Cal Newport, a super smart assistant professor who created a blog called Study Hacks, targeting college students, but I find that so many of his posts apply to everyone, like today's. But before we get to it, thank you to LaCroix Sparkling Water for their support. It's a no-calorie, no-sweetener, and no-sodium beverage with nothing artificial, just a hint of fruit essences so you can have a tastier version of water. Make the switch to LaCroix Sparkling Water. A listener of this show did and loves it. I'll talk about that at the end. But for now, check them out at LaCroixWater.com or on your favorite social network at LaCroix Water. That's LacroixWater.com. So let's get right to the post as we optimize your life. A whirlwind tour of getting things done by Cal Newport of calnewport.com. The two big ideas behind GTD. Over 20 years ago, David Allen began a storied career of seeking and describing optimal productivity techniques. The result of his work was captured in the book, Getting Things Done, first published in 2001. The GTD methodology immediately resonated with the fatigued denizens of the technology-saturated 500 emails a day new economy. It became a national bestseller, selling over 500,000 copies, and was republished in 23 foreign languages. Even today, it remains in the top 500 on Amazon sales rankings, and has spawned thriving web communities devoted to his teachings. What's so special about this system? Its main tenets can be reduced to two big ideas. One, you have to control your stuff. Simply put, any obligation, task, idea, or deadline that you're keeping track of only in your head is draining your mental resources. This causes stress and makes it difficult to reach the state of relaxed concentration needed to work effectively. A central idea behind GTD is that all of your stuff has to get out of your mind. This means that incoming information is quickly shunted to a small number of well-defined collection bins from where it's processed into a trusted system that you regularly review. This idea is devastatingly powerful. Once you've taken the time to pour everything out of your head and onto paper, you'll be shocked by the sheer volume of information your mind was trying to juggle and maintain. The sense of relief that follows from this process goes a long way toward understanding the cult-like devotion shown to Mr. Allen by many. Number two, you manage actions. You don't do projects, you do specific actions. As long as your work is recorded in terms of large-scale lumps of obligations, such as write book proposal, it is difficult to get started. Our days are too busy to tackle something so amorphous and intimidating. GTD forces you to reduce everything down to a specific next action. Instead of write book proposal, you might use Amazon to find 10 competitive titles for book proposal. In GTD, these specific actions are what you manage. At any one point during the day, the decision you make is, what action should I do next? This approach provides greater clarity to your day-to-day productivity as it reduces everything from mundane chores to making progress on huge life goals down to the same manageable scale. The hidden advantage of this idea is that it stops you from having to make big picture decisions. What work is important to my life during the day? In GTD, these big questions are considered less frequently during, for example, a weekly review, at which point they are transformed into specific next actions, which can be processed more mindlessly during the heat of battle. A quick summary of the GTD methodology. The basic materials you need for GTD are the following. Number one, a small number of collection bins. For example, your email inbox, a physical inbox on your desk, and some sort of notepad or planner that you carry with you. Number two, a calendar. Number three, next action list. Number four, project list. And number five, a filing system. Collection. In GTD, when new stuff enters your world, you need to immediately place it in one of your well-defined collection bins. Stuff in this context defines any sort of information that might require you to do something. Note, this includes everything from specific tasks, return library books, to bigger projects, figure out plan for tackling Anderson account, to brainstorms, maybe I should start a blog. Make no distinction between work and personal life. Stuff is stuff, it has to get out of your head. For email, this collection happens automatically. Consider your email inbox a collection bin. You will need a physical inbox to collect things such as letters, memos, and notes. You will also need a portable inbox to quickly jot down stuff that you encounter away from your primary workspace, e.g., in a meeting, you were assigned to look into a new product. A planner, notepad, or even a sheet of scrap paper, as I advocate in Straight A, should suffice. Processing. A key behavior in GTD is processing the items that build up in your various collection bins. You need to do this regularly, for example, at least once a day. Here's a processing decision tree laid out by Mr. Allen for tackling this task. For each item, number one, decide if it requires action on your part. If it doesn't, either delegate, discard, or file it for later reference. Otherwise, number two, identify the specific next action required by this item. If it requires more than one action, then identify the first of these actions and make a note of the bigger project on your projects list. If this action can be completed in 2 minutes or less, do it right now. Number three, if the action needs to be completed on or by a given date, record it on this date in your calendar. Otherwise, number four, record the action on your next actions list. Reviewing. In GTD, reviews of your stuff occurs at multiple levels. At the lowest level, you're making decisions during the day regarding what action you should do next. This process is simple. First, check your calendar to see if there's a time-sensitive material you should be working on. If not, look through your next actions list and choose something reasonable to tackle, given your energy, available time, and location. There are numerous ways you might structure your next actions list to make the decision easier. Mr. Allen suggests dividing it into contexts, such as phone calls, at my desk, at home, working online, and deciding what to do next by reviewing the list associated with your current context. At a slightly higher level, you need to review your next actions list, combining, modifying, and consolidating actions as appropriate. In addition, you need to look over your projects list and, where needed, add actions to your next action list that'll help you make progress on the projects you deem to be active at the moment. You should also make sure that any stuff lingering in your head or in ad hoc piles around your desk is moved into a collection bin and then processed. In GTD, this intermediate review happens once a week. It's a way to plug leaks and help you reflect on what work you want to get done in the near future. At the highest level, you want to occasionally check in and reflect on your goals in life, your one-year plan, and where you are headed. Such consideration might lead to the addition of new projects to your project list and/or the deletion of projects that no longer seem relevant. For GTD to work, all three levels of reviewing must occur regularly. Conclusion. Following the GTD approach can be summarized as follows. Number one, get all of the stuff in your life out of your mind and into collection bins. Number two, process these bins at least once a day. Number three, during the day, use your calendar and next actions list to help decide what to do next. Number four, once a week, clean up your system and check in on your projects list. And number five, every few months, reflect on the big picture questions in your life and make sure these are reflected in your projects and next actions list. You just listened to the post titled "A Whirlwind Tour of Getting Things Done" by Cal Newport of calnewport.com. And thank you to LaCroix Sparkling Water for sponsoring this episode. Water gets boring fast, and drinking sodas all the time is something I try to avoid. I don't know about you. Why deal with extra calories, sodium, and sweeteners? Make the switch to LaCroix Sparkling Water, a healthier alternative for you and your lifestyle. I had a listener write in and reached out to the company to thank them for sponsoring this podcast because he found out about LaCroix, made the switch from soda, and is now getting the benefits, but still satisfies the craving for flavor. I was so happy to hear that. And there are 14 LaCroix flavors like orange, lemon, cran raspberry. There's also coconut, key lime, and more, including 6 LaCroix Kurate flavors like pineapple strawberry, cherry lime, and a lot more. They're certified kosher, gluten-free, vegan, and non-GMO, and as I mentioned, no calories, sweeteners, or sodium. You can check them out, see a full list of retailers on their site, lacroixwater.com, and join their community on your favorite social network, at lacroixwater. That's lacroixwater.com, and I have it linked in this episode's description. And today's one of those episodes where I'm probably gonna have to go back and just read through this and crank it out. This is a huge productivity hack. Definitely try it out if it's something that you struggle with. I know I'm going to. And that should do it for today. Happy Sunday. Hope you're having a great weekend if you're listening in real time. And I'll see you tomorrow where your optimal life awaits.
Hey, this is Dan from the Optimal Finance Daily podcast, which is a lot like this show, except more focused on personal finance. Justin handpicks the best posts he can find from blogs and authors like Ramit Sethi, Mr. Money Mustache, and more, and I read them to you 5 days a week. So if you enjoy this podcast, come on over and subscribe to Optimal Finance Daily too. And together, we'll optimize your financial life.
You've been listening to Optimal Living Daily. Be sure to hit the subscribe button to stay up to date on each new episode and head to oldpodcast.com. That's OLDpodcast.com for a free gift as well as more actionable tips and resources to help you maximize your potential. Thanks for joining us, and remember, your optimal life awaits.